What's going on, guys? It's your boy Uch, and I am here and now. Still kind of recouping from recent events that have taken place in my life, but obviously not here to talk about that. Aside from, yeah, but anyway, the title, obviously, we're talking about Godzilla. I got my Godzilla shirt, you guys can see. Just got back, it's about 2:30 in the morning right now. I just wanted to get my review about it, and my voice is kind of, like, scratchy, because I am still trying to get over, like, a minor head cold. I'm, like, all congested up here, but, and it did not help that I yelled at the end of the movie, because it was pretty, I was pretty excited, but just to give you guys a wrap-up thoughts review on my whole entire experience, not just with watching King of the Monsters, but also with my build-up towards watching it, my hype towards watching it, because it was literally like at the beginning of May that I found out that there was going to be a new Godzilla movie, and it kind of like caught me off by surprise, and I had no idea. So being that I was really excited to watch the 2014 movie when it came out in theaters, I was like, oh man, like, I should probably check this out. I should probably, you know, I want to go into it with a more clear mind and, you know, like a more educated mind at the same time, because, like, I know that it's called being called King of the Monsters. We were going to see, you know, Ghidorah. We were going to see Rodan. We were going to see Mothra, you know, besides Godzilla, on top of a bunch of other things that happened in the film and a lot of references that were made. And I'm glad that I took the decision that I did with educating myself and pretty much going back and watching like a lot of the classics. Now, I didn't go and watch every single one from 54 all the way until like what was it, King Kong Skull Island, which, yes, it does play a role in the overall monster universe that has started with the 2014 film, for those that don't know. It goes 2014 Godzilla, Skull Island, and then this new one, King of Monsters, in that order. So pretty much, I went on Twitter, for those that don't know, and I asked everyone, like, for someone like me who is a fan of Godzilla but hasn't seen a lot of the older ones, which movies should I watch? And people gave me their suggestions, and I pretty much had around like 10 movies, all spanning from the 60s, 70s, all the eras pretty much, like 60s, 70s, 80s, 90s, even the millennium, like 2000s, and then even the more current ones, obviously with the 2014 film and the Kong movie. So surprisingly, I finished all of them. All of the ones that were suggested to me, and it was just enough to get my mind set for going into King of Monsters. And I gotta say, for being someone that pretty much played like a crash course session, and to try to, because I didn't really grow up with Godzilla, I was aware of Godzilla, I liked the idea of Godzilla, I thought it was really cool to see big giant monsters, you know, destroying other monsters and whatnot, you know, a lot of chaos. I thought that was cool, like, as a kid when I was around it, but I was more, you know, I was more exposed to, you know, Power Rangers, Dragon Ball Z, Pokemon, stuff like that. And, you know, we did have similar things, like, you know, with Megazords and, like, you know, big giant apes, and I know it had nothing to do with what the things that I just said, but of course there's Reptar in Rugrats, so that's a weird comparison reference to make, but, you know, I have to obviously say that. But, you know, just to give you guys an insight on, like, where I'm at with Godzilla. So, I can't really call myself a huge fan, but I feel like I'm becoming one, especially considering that I watched, like, 10 movies in the span of 2 weeks that were just Godzilla films. And I have a lot of honest mixed reviews on them, which you can definitely find on my Twitter. I made a bunch of different threads. But as far as all that, I'm sorry that if you're waiting for my actual thoughts, for I had to get that out there first so that way you guys understand where I'm coming from and all that kind of stuff. So apologies on that, but I feel like it is important to note King of Monsters was OD. It was actually really good. I enjoyed it from start to finish. A lot of the scenes with the humans, I want to call it like the build up and like the actual story portion of it. Because a lot of people, they might criticize these films or this one in particular as a movie that's not as good or something that is like, bad. I mean, obviously, when you see Godzilla on the marquee, you want to see a monster fight. You want to see Godzilla fight Ghidorah, fight whoever the hell is in front of him. Because normally a lot of the movies are actually Godzilla versus somebody, right? And that's fine and all, but like there comes a point where it's just like, all right, well, if there was, if there was a film that was just like, they just threw these monsters out, they're like, all right, we're gonna watch these monsters just fight, go at it for like an hour and a half straight without any kind of reasoning, like, after a while, yeah, sure, it would be really cool, but I feel like there has to be some kind of direction, some kind of like foreground, so that way we have an idea of what actually is going on. I thought that all of the build up with the humans and the actual plot of the story, involving, all the nuclear stuff and, the plan going forward with trying to, ultimately destroy these titans. I like how they refer to the monsters as titans and not monsters, because they are, I feel like, if you're referring to something as a titan, it is bigger than a monster. And they are way too big to just be called monsters. When you think of monsters, you think of like the boogeyman or something like that. But like these guys, Godzilla and the Grant and the gang, they're titans. Okay, they're ginormous. They're way bigger than just old monsters. So I will give a shout out to that. I do appreciate how they actually refer to them as titans. And so of course, like the plan to eradicate them or to, do something with them because, a lot of the humanistic, I guess, traits that we see shown in this movie is that obviously when we don't understand something, we just want to kill it, right? So in this film, they obviously do that. There's like two sides to it. I don't want to spoil too much again, also, because I do want you guys to see it. And I will say this, I'm sure a lot of people might agree with me on this at least, but I feel like if you're not a fan of Godzilla in some capacity, like even if you don't, like if you've never seen a Godzilla movie before, I feel like you may not enjoy this as much. But if you go into it with an optimistic view, with it like a, with an open mind, and you kind of like take it as is, I feel like the movie does a pretty good job with being a standalone film. Like if you went into it not even knowing that there was a prequel, like 2014, I feel like they didn't even reference that one so much to the point where if you didn't see it, you'd be missing out on things that happened in this. The on my honest opinion is I feel like you'd be missing out on references and things that they pay homage to and such if you didn't see the original films, not even the 2014 one. Because of course, with this new monster verse, they should call it a Titan verse, but monster verse makes more sense. With this new monster verse that they started in with Lionsgate, or no, not Lionsgate, I forget. Wow, brain fart, scratch that. But with this new monster verse that they're starting, since 2014, obviously they're taking reference and material source material from the original Toho films, from Japan and whatnot. And they are pretty much setting the standard. And so the one thing that they do pay reference that they did refer to in the last film, 2014 Godzilla, is they always pay back to the 1950s. So they use the original first movie as like the first ground basis of where Godzilla's origins come from, but this movie actually goes deeper than that, and that was something that I wasn't expecting at all, and I thought that that really opened my eyes to like the complete lore of Godzilla. Like there is way more than just nuclear waste build up into this former dinosaur type of creature. Like trust me guys, it goes way deeper than that. And I do feel like this movie kind of threw that in there as a almost like a surprise factor because it was necessary to further explain Godzilla's overall like power and strength. And I'm saying power and strength for now because I don't want to actually spoil like what happens, but I hope that what I'm saying is getting you guys interested enough to go see it if you haven't already. So yeah, my review of this movie is that it was fine. I thought it was really good. I thought it was a good enough balance between, you know, the build-up, the setup, the human scenes. Because again, without the human scenes, we don't understand where the movie's going. We don't really get like where the conflict is outside of the obvious. The fights, I felt like they were done really well. Of course, movie is CGI heavy, but you know, that is the world we live in now. The technology is at this standard where we can make movies that look hella realistic to the point where it's just like damn, like I'm scared to just look out my window and then next thing you know I see Rodan just flying in the sky just chilling or something. But yeah, I thought that, you know, it was really well done. The soundtrack that was used was very good. I'll just put it this way. I'm glad that I took the time to go and actually watch all the suggested movies, the recommendations that I got on Twitter. So if you made a recommendation to me on Twitter, I appreciate you. Thank you very much. It did give me a lot of good insight going forward into this film, and it definitely prepared me mentally a lot. So I'm really thankful for that. And I guess a tidbit, if you're wanting to go into this, like if you're like me, likes to go into a movie knowing, like, you know, like some foreground information, like, you know, I don't have like a clean slate going in, like I got knowledge in this head, like I've seen, you know, Versus Ghidorah, I've seen Rodan the standalone, I've seen Final Wars, I've seen Versus Mothra, I've seen a bunch of different ones, like, you know, I've seen ones that had nothing to do with this one, you know, just to get more of an idea of, you know, exactly, you know, what like Godzilla movies are all about. And like I said in the beginning, like, you know, in the more beginning of this review, you know, I have a lot of mixed feelings about the past ones, but as far as King of the Monsters goes, it's definitely not, I'm not going to say it's better than Avengers, it's not better than Broly, because that's, you know, you guys know who me for what you know me for, but it's definitely up there, I will say that right now. As far as 2019 goes, I feel like it's definitely my top three. King of the Monsters does a really good job. I don't think there's really anything bad with it. And when I'm very optimistic. Like, I really find all the good in things. And I personally just was not, like, bored at all. I wasn't, like, you know, I wasn't feeling like I was sitting there and I was just like, okay, like, when are they going to fight? Like, I felt like everything that they did in the film had a purpose. It was purposeful, and there was, you know, a lot of you know, like reasoning behind the things that went down and that led into the things that they led into. So if you guys are interested in hearing a spoiler review, let me know in the comments and I'll definitely consider doing a spoiler review, because there is some stuff that happens in the after credits that is really interesting, and it actually makes me want to go back and watch all the movies that I didn't see yet, because I feel like there's some missing things that obviously no one that obviously didn't already see this. They did not know to tell me, oh, you should watch this one too, just in case. But now I feel like I definitely do. So I'm sucked in. I will also say this, the ending scenes, like during the credits, had me screaming. Okay, I'm just excited. Like, the next movie, if you don't already know, that one that's already confirmed, so I'm not going to say what it is, but it's already been out there, so this is public knowledge at this point, so that's technically not a spoiler, but I'm being nice about it. Go Google it, you'll see what's coming next year, and you'll understand why I was beating my chest. So, again, hopefully I'll be back with more videos soon. I gotta take my time with things, as you guys may know. I revealed it, so you guys, it's out there, so you guys know what's been going on here. But I appreciate you guys for coming in, watching this review of Godzilla King of the Monsters. It was amazing. It was awesome. I actually would probably go see it again if I had the opportunity to. So thanks again, guys. It's been your boy, Uch. Follow me on Twitter, all that good stuff. All the supporting links in the description, as always. And I'll see you guys next time.